जोर माइसेल्फ डॉक्टर कुशाग्र दुबे एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर स्मृति कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल एजुकेशन इंदौर टुडे द टॉपिक ऑफ वीडियो इज ओटीसी मेडिकेशन ओवर द काउंटर मेडिकेशंस सो इन दिस फर्स्ट वी हैव टू स्टडी व्हाट इज रैशनल यूज ऑफ ड्रग्स रैशनल यूज ऑफ मेडिसिन रिफर्स टू द करेक्ट प्रॉपर एंड अप्रोप्रिएट यूज ऑफ मेडिसिन Rational use requires that patient receives the appropriate medicine in the proper dose for an adequate period of time and at the lowest cost. And use of an appropriate, efficacious, safe and cost-effective drug given for the right indication in the right dose and formulation at right intervals and for the right duration of time. So this is rational use of drugs means use of the correct, proper and appropriate use of medicines and the patient receives the correct dose of irrationality. Ineffective and unsafe drug treatment, inappropriate self-medication, worsening or prolonging of illness. Now, consequences of irrational use of medicines. Incorrect use of medicine occur in all countries, causing harm to people and wasting resources. The consequences include like antimicrobial resistance, overuse of antibiotics, increase antimicrobial resistance and the number of medicines that are no longer effective against infectious disease. Adverse drug reaction and medication error. Harmful reaction to medicine caused by wrong use or allergic reactions to medicine can lead to increased illness, suffering and death. Lost resources. 10 to 40% of national budget are spent on medicines. Out of pocket purchase of medicine can cause severe financial hardship to individual and their families. If medicines are not prescribed and used properly, millions or billions of the rupees of public and personal funds are wasted. So, eroded patient confidence, exacerbated by the overuse of limited medicine and drugs, may be often out of stock or at unaffordable price, and as a result, erode patient confidence, poor or negative health outcome due to inappropriate use of medicine may also reduce confidence. So, these are the consequences. Factors contribute to incorrect use of medicine. First one is lack of skill and knowledge, inappropriate unethical promotion of medicine by pharmaceutical company, profit from selling medicine, unrestricted availability of medicine, overworked health personnel, unaffordable medicine. These are the factors that contribute to incorrect use of medicine. The most important is lack of skill and knowledge. So, what can be done to improve rational use of medicine? WHO advises countries to implement national program to promote rational use of medicine through policies, structures, information and education. This includes a national body to coordinate policies on medicine use and monitor their impact. Evidence-based clinical guidelines for supervision and supporting decision-making about medicine. List of essential medicine used for medicine procurement and insurance reimbursement. So WHO advised the countries they may have what to do for the rational use of drugs. Drug or medicine and therapeutic committee in district and hospital to monitor and implement intervention to improve the use of medicine. Problem-based training in pharmacotherapy and prescribing in undergraduate curricula. continuing medication education as a requirement of license 0. Publicly available independent and unbiased information about medicine for health personnel and consumer. Public education about medicine. These are the very important points. Elimination of financial incentives that lead to improper prescribing, such as prescribers selling medicine for profit to supplement their income. Regulation to ensure that promotional activities meet ethical criteria and adequate funding to ensure availability of medicine and health personnel. The most effective approach to improve medicine use in primary care in developing country is a combination of education and supervision of health personnel, consumer education, and ensuring an adequate supply of appropriate medicine. Now, irrational drug combination. If the combination of drug is illogical in terms of plasma half-life and pharmacokinetic of the drug, the combination should be termed as irrational drug combination. Large number of such irrational drug combination are available in the market, which unnecessarily increase the cost of medication and add to the side effect of the therapy. Means plasma half-life and pharmacokinetic of the drug. These are the important criteria. Example is ampicillin plus doxycycline. Ampicillin is effective against gram-negative bacilli, but doxycycline is an anti-staphylococcal penicillin and not effective against gram-negative bacilli. Mixed gram-negative and staphylococcal infection rarely coexist. So, in a patient with a single infection, one of the drug of the combination would be useless. In addition to the cost of therapy, it would add to adverse side effect and resistance of bacteria to the drug. On the other hand, the combination would reduce the dose of effective drug to the half, and the patient would need longer course of therapy. So this is the one example. Next is antibacterial plus antiamoebic combination, NSAIDs combination. So these are the examples. Now, if we talk about the analgesic, pain relief medicines, also known as analgesic and painkillers, are regulated by the Food and Drug Administration, that is FDA. Some analgesic, including opioid analgesic, act on the body's peripheral and central nervous system to block or decrease sensitivity to pain. Other act by inhibiting the formation of certain chemical in the body. These relieve the minor aches and pains associated with conditions such as headache, fever, cold, flu, arthritis, toothache, and other cramps. These are basically two types of OTC pain relievers: acetaminophen and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Acetaminophen is an active ingredient found in more than 6,000 TC and prescription medicines, including pain relievers, cough suppressant, and cold medication. NSAIDs are common medication used to relieve fever and minor aches and pains. They include aspirin, naproxen, and ibuprofen, as well as many medicines taken for cold, sinus pressure, and allergies. They act by inhibiting an enzyme that helps make a specific chemical. So these are the examples of analgesic: acetaminophen and NSAIDs. Use as directed. Pain medications are safe and effective when used as directed. However, misuse of this product can be extremely harmful and even deadly. Consumer who take pain relief medication must follow their healthcare professional instruction carefully. If a measuring tool is provided with your medicine, use it as directed. Do not change the dose of your pain relief medication without talking to your doctor first. Also, pain medication could never be shared with anyone else. Only your healthcare professional can decide If a prescription pen medication is safe for someone, if you are taking ibuprofen and our friend is complaining, don't share with your friend. Take it. This is a pain relief medication. Okay. So, pain relief medication should never be shared with anyone. Key points to remember: with acetaminophen, taking a higher dose than recommended will not provide more relief and can be dangerous. We are not take to more dose. Too much can lead to liver damage and death. Risk of liver damage may be increased in people who drink 3 or more alcoholic beverages a day while using acetaminophen containing medicine. Precautions when giving acetaminophen to children. Infant drug medication can be significantly stronger than regular children medication. And read and follow the direction on the label every time you use a medicine. Be sure that infant is getting the infant's pain formula and your older child is getting the children's pain formula. Means we have not to combine both the formulas and give infant to the children dose and children to the infant dose. But NSS, too much can cause stomach bleeding. This risk increases in people who are over 60 years of age, are taking prescription blood thinners, are taking steroids, have a history of stomach bleeding or ulcer, or have other bleeding problem. Use of NSAIDs can also cause kidney damage. This risk may increase in people who are over 60 years of age, are taking a diuretic, have high blood pressure, have heart diseases or have the kidney diseases. If we talk about opioids, use of opioids can lead to drowsiness. Do not drive or use any machinery that may injure you, especially when you first start the medication. The dose of opioid pain medication that is safe for you could be high enough to cause an overdose and death in someone, especially the children. If we take opioids overdose, the death may occurs. It leads to drowsiness also, so we should not drive when taking the opioids. It may cause an accident. Okay, so we should not take the overdose of the medicines. It is very harmful for us. If we take the too much of NSAIDs, then stomach bleeding occurs. Okay, now the active ingredient. A specific area of concern with OTC pen medication is when products sold for different uses have the same ingredient. A cold and cough remedy may have the same active ingredient as a headache or as a prescription pain reliever. To minimize the risk of an accidental overdose, consumers should avoid taking multiple medication with the same active ingredient at the same time. All OTC medicines must have all their active ingredients listed on the package. For prescription drugs, the active ingredients are listed on the container label. So we have to talk to our pharmacist or the doctor if we have a question about OTC medicines which we are using, and especially before using them in combination with dietary supplements or with the other OTC or prescription medicine. So, the means the problem is that the different product have the same active ingredient. Okay. Inject them. Commonly abused of point pen medicine include codeine. Example is codeine. And the brand name product oxycontin, vincodine and demiro. Addiction is just one serious danger of opioid abuse. The number of overdose that have resulted from snorting and injecting opioid, particularly the drug oxycontin. So, if we talk about the opioids, then the overdose cause we got addicted. But if we take overdose, then it can lead to the death. Okay. And National Institute of Health Studies said that if we take the proper dose or taken exactly as prescribed, then it will not be harm to us. There were some steps to use opioid safely. First one, keep your doctor informed. Inform your healthcare professional about any past history of substance abuse. All push patients treated with opioid for pain require careful monitoring by their healthcare professional for sign of abuse and addiction, and to determine when these analgesics are no longer needed. Follow direction carefully. Opioids are associated with significant side effects, including drowsiness, constipation, and depressed breathing, depending on the amount taken. Taking too much could cause severe respiratory depression or death. Do not crush or break pills. This can alter the rate at which the medication is absorbed and lead to overdose and death. It reduces the risk of drug interaction. Don't mix opioid with alcohol, antihistamine, barbiturates or benzodiazepine. All of these substances show slow breathing and their combined effects could lead to life-threatening respiratory depression. So these are the some key points we have to keep in mind by using the opioids. Keep your doctor. We have to inform the doctor. We have to follow direction carefully. It reduces the risk of drug interaction if we take it proper amount. Cough suppressants. The role of cough medicine is to ease symptoms while your body heals. OTC cough medication are only three basic types. We know that expectorant, suppressant, combination cough products. If we talk about expectorant, they have thin mucus making it easier to cough up or spit from the body. Main ingredient is the guaifenesin. If we talk about the suppressant, it has cut the number of times you cough. The active ingredient listed is usually dextromethorphan. Other cough suppressants include camphor, eucalyptus oil and menthol. Combination cough products have more than one active ingredient. They have both guaifenesin and dextromethorphan. Cough medicines may also contain ingredients to help coat and soothing the throat. So, these are the cough suppressants. They are basically of three types: expectorant, suppressant, and the combination. Combination product may have medicine to ease other symptoms that may include decongestants for stuffy nose, antihistamines for allergy or a runny nose, or painkillers. Choose a medicine that matches your symptom. Cough drops can also help to relieve a cough and may ease a sore throat. Cough suppressant containing opioid should be taken with extreme caution. The main ingredient of opioid cough suppressant are dextromethorphan. So, this is about the cough. Now, how to use cough medication safely? Look at the ingredient, check the label. It is a suppressant or expectorant, or it is a both or the combination. Make sure we are getting what we need. Don't use medicine for more than 7 days. We have to always measure the correct dose, because even same medicine in high dose can be very dangerous. High dose of cough medicine can cause serious problem like brain damage, seizure or death. So we have to choose an optimum amount or as prescribed by our doctor. We can ask the pharmacist also, or also it is written on the label. Be careful with combination medicines. Many OTC cough medicines have multiple ingredients, expectorants and suppressant along with decongestants, antihistamine or painkiller. We have to select product with only the medicine that treat our symptom. If our symptom is only a cough, we don't need a decongestant or painkiller. If we need to treat multiple symptoms, we have to check other medicines what we want to take to see if they contain the same ingredient. We don't have to take two medicines that have the same ingredient. If we have any question, then we have to ask our pharmacist or the doctor. Keep away you from our children's. Make sure to choose the right medicines based on your child age. Don't give cough and cold medicine to children under age 4. For kids 4 to 6, we have to ask our doctor first and always make sure to follow the dosing direction of the label. We have to consider doing nothing. Waiting out a cough is the simplest option. In the 7 days, it may be healed. Remember that most cough don't need treatment. You all know we don't have to take any medicine. Give a baby a week and the cough will probably go away. If it doesn't, then we have to go on the doctor. Read the label after we choose the right medicine for us. First, we have to read the label carefully and understand how to take it. This is important. NSAIDs are the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. They are one of the two major types of OTC pain reliever. The other is acetaminophen, Tylenol. A few different types of NSAIDs are available over the counter. We know that aspirin, ibuprofen, naproxen. NSAIDs are used to reduce fever and relieve mild aches and pains. They can be used for everything from a mild tooth or headache to cramp. Many people also use NSAIDs to relieve the pain of arthritis or to treat the aches and pains of the common cold and flu also. They work by blocking enzymes in the body that help more chemicals that signal pain. When these enzymes are blocked, we will feel less pain. So generally, we are taking the NSAIDs like aspirin, ibuprofen. These are the common drugs. Now, if we talk about the special patient group, then first we have to talk to our doctor before taking the NSAID. If the age is over 60, pregnant or nursing woman, have 3 or more drink of alcohol every day, have bleeding problem, have liver or kidney disease, heart disease. Take a medicine to thin the blood, like if we are taking the warfarin already and if we are taking the drug for the high blood pressure. Children and teenagers who are recovering from a viral infection like flu, chickenpox should not take the aspirin. It has been linked to rare syndrome. Sorry. A serious but rare condition that can result in brain, kidney and liver damage. Naproxen sodium is not recommended for children under 2 years. Ibuprofen is considered to be a good for the pain relief. To reduce our risk of problem with NSAIDs, we have to try some tips like don't drink alcohol. Drinking alcohol while we are taking an NSAID increase risk of bleeding. Take NSAIDs with food and water. If we have a history of stomach problem, first we have to ask our doctor about taking a drug that blocks stomach acid with the NSAID. When choosing pain relief medication, it is the most important to take the lowest dose that works for us and to take it as a directed. And if our pain continues for more than 10 days or isn't controlled by the NSAIDs, then we have to consult our doctor. So this is all about the how to use rational use of drugs.